I'm gonna get deep. I'm gonna get
yeah. No, I'm gonna can go deep and we can go up to the sky. You know?
In my career, I was so career focused. The struggle for the job, employable, and that people are liking what I'm doing.
Right.
I wasn't focusing on the things that I loved in the first place. Mm. And I need to do some stuff for me.
Yeah.
Oh, you think this is what we want, as opposed to what do you want? What am I really trying to preserve? Is it my ego or is it the work?
Mm.
I think the most important thing is with story art.
Sometimes when I hear what other people talks about their struggles or how they overcome the struggles or so can you maybe share maybe something that you just kind of what kind of struggle maybe you had recently and how do you overcome it? You started the new job about 3 months ago.
Yeah.
And then was there any struggles working there, or was there any struggles maybe in the past? Maybe you can share anything, wherever you feel comfortable.
Yeah, sure. I mean, I think the thing I've learned in the past year or so, I'm gonna get deep. I'm gonna get
personal. yeah. No, I feel this can be anything.
Yeah.
We can go deep and we can go up to the sky.
Sure. I think that early on, in my career, I was so career focused, right? And I still am, but
yeah.
But the idea of the struggle for the job, to make sure that I'm doing what is needed, and that I'm employable, and that people are liking what I'm doing.
Right.
I got very focused on the job part of it. That I think I was too into that, and I wasn't focusing on the things that I loved in the first place, which is a bit of the art of it, the creativity of it, right?
Yeah.
TV animation, again, better or worse, you do get, it can really be a grind, and it can really become, once you get comfortable with a project, you're on this project, and you're doing this one thing, and then I think I would get really fixated on, okay, I gotta make this thing a thing, and then what I lost was, I wasn't coming up with ideas, because what's the point? I have the scripts, if my ideas for this don't matter.
Yeah.
And not in a bad way, but just the way that it is it's a script driven thing.
Yeah.
So I would kind of focus on the work and I'd focus on all that stuff, and I wasn't being creative. I wasn't doing anything either for me or expressing ideas or whatever. So what I think I learned in the past few years is to kind of step back from the job, keep my job my job.
Yes.
When I'm there, I'm doing it.
Yeah.
It's amazing that I'm making my livelihood in the arts. It's a very privileged position.
Man. Oh, yeah.
I don't take that for granted for a second. But at the same time, to say, okay, they have me for this amount of time. This is the time I'm devoting to this.
Yeah.
And I need to do some stuff for me.
Yeah.
Which people have said, and I've heard that on podcasts, and I've heard that on things.
Yeah.
And I would always go, well, it's so easy to just say, do your own stuff, but when do you have time? What's the, And then I think it's just that allowing that mental space to think about, okay, I'm a little bit more established now in this career. I know that I'm employable. I know that I can, deliver what people want out of me.
Yeah.
I don't need to be so intensely concerned about that.
Yeah.
What I can do with that mental space now is I can allocate some stuff that while I'm working on this, I could also be thinking, okay, what would I be doing? What could I do? What's the thing that would interest me more, in my own, not in regards to this show, but just
for yourself.
What would I create?
Yeah.
What would I want to do?
Yeah.
And just I've started doing some more like personal projects and some more like personal storyboards and like that kind of stuff is really, I don't know, that like having that inspiration, like having, allowing that creativity to come out again is really important.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
I don't even know what the question was. No, I'm like,
I think
no, I'm
you're,
like, I'm,
you're, yeah, you're,
I hope I'm hovering around.
No, you're actually answering all that stuff.
Okay,
you're actually answering more than what I was expecting. So I think that's good. And you, I think, do also mention, just before this, you do mention that you, pitching to different studios. So is this
so
like also part of your personal,
big part of it.
Okay.
So I, and this has been a big, I'm gonna shout out a friend of mine on here.
Yeah.
I've been working with a friend who isn't in the animation industry at all.
Oh no.
He's actually like a comedian and a writer.
All right. There
Okay. And his name's Attuah. He's
okay.
Awesome.
Okay.
What's his handle? Yeah, Yao Experience. Oh. Look him up. Attuah.
Okay.
Y-A-W,
okay.
A-T-T-A.
Does he have like a Instagram
U-A-H.
And stuff or something?
Yes.
Okay.
He's got all the things.
So
the
I'll
Instagram.
Probably, maybe like after this interview, you can maybe share his Instagram and your Instagram. So I could post on the YouTube.
Absolutely.
Well. So, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah.
He's funny. He's awesome.
Okay.
You'll enjoy him. Anyway, but so we've become friends and we would always talk about, you know, our shared interests and like we love a lot of the same stuff. And at one point we were just like, we should work on something together. We should find something that we could do together. So working with him has been like this really fun collaboration that like we did kind of come up with a TV series pitch together. And we recently like went out and pitched it in LA. Like we went to some major studios and and pitched
you went there with him?
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, we went together.
Together, yeah.
And we actually met through our significant others. My wife and his fiance are like super good friends.
Oh, all right.
And they, like, as they became friends, they were talking about us, and they were like, oh, those guys sound like they would get along. So we made it into a, like, a pitching vacation, but also, a, like, the four of us.
Yeah,
like, the two
yeah,
couples
yeah.
went out. It was really fun.
Yeah.
Anyway, point is, it's taken me on this whole new journey of like really being creative and like really coming up with ideas and doing character designs again, which like I haven't done in since school.
Really?
You know?
Okay.
Yeah, because I got so into boarding and as I said, like the professionalism of it all that like I just all that stuff kind of fell away. So like rediscovering how much fun that can be was really cool.
Yeah.
Coming up with like series ideas and whatever, so that's like really reignited like the passion that I have. And
that's awesome, man.
Yeah, and it's been like something that we're still pursuing, like we did the pitch, not expecting anything to come of it, but it's this great experience of getting to meet people and talk and just it's leading us to just more ideas and more things. So anyway, like we're constantly talking about like the next thing we can do together, and we're coming up with more ideas. We just started. You know what? I'm gonna say this on here,
all right.
Because it's gonna inspire me to motivate us to actually do it.
Oh.
Because now that it's out.
Okay.
That like there has to be content.
Oh.
So we started like a production company.
Okay, there you go.
Well,
what is it called?
It's called Funny Ghost Productions.
Funny Ghost Productions. Okay, that sounds good.
Yeah. And so that's our banner in which we're creating our content.
Mm-hmm.
And we're now on Instagram.
Okay.
Funny Ghost Productions.
Oh, nice.
And we're doing kind of like little comic strips and like concepts and like fun ideas. We're thinking of our Instagram account as our like variety show.
Oh.
So like we're doing like, you know, like sketches and like little comic strips and just like fun things that are coming out on there. So now that I've said it, we have to do it.
All right.
So
so you guys already created the account and you're okay.
And we're starting it up right now. That we're starting all the to write some content and like it's our newest collaboration together.
All right. There
so,
you go. That's awesome.
So you got a scoop, whatever that means.
Yeah.
But
well, I mean, like we could also put that link below so people
please,
can check it
great.
Out.
Yeah,
that'll be awesome.
It is. It is to say that it is like I found it so important to actually like make sure that like whatever it is, whether it's like, I just love, like, opening that, mm-hmm. that floodgate of, like, allow ideas to come out and, like, explore them and see what I can do with them. Mm. And, yeah, to say, like, why not pitch to, like,
yeah.
to, why not go to L.A. and pitch to DreamWorks, which we did?
Yeah.
Like,
oh, okay.
Like,
yeah.
okay, why
yeah.
not?
Yeah.
Who's stopping me?
Yeah.
You know?
Nobody.
Who's stopping
nobody.
Us?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So,
yeah, 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 yeah. That's the thing. I think, you know, like, you know, even like some of the show that they made, like How to Train Your Dragon,
mm.
that was, I think, based on children's book.
Yeah.
And Boss Baby, that
right.
was also children's book.
Yeah.
Yeah. I actually met the author when
oh,
I was
no
in Vancouver.
Way.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, cool.
There was a talk she gave, and then we have a group of writers and illustrator, you know, group, and then we went there. And then after, and then she actually mentioned that, like, okay, you know, I wrote this book, you know, it took like about this much time, and now DreamWorks, will making a movie, you know, about this book. And then after a year later, they actually did.
There
it
was.
So, yeah, so...
That's
yeah,
so cool.
Yeah.
And that, you know, that's another thing that I've been
mm-hmm.
exploring, too, is just, like, it, you know, it was great to make the pitch and to do the thing. We actually,
But what was their feedback? What, did you guys have a good positive? Like,
yeah, we had
okay.
great feedback.
Oh.
We were actually really, like, pleasantly surprised
really?
with the feedback that we got. Yeah, I mean... we went to these big studios, like, and, you know,
yeah.
there's no reason to
mm-hmm.
expect that they'd be like, we love it, here you go, we're making a show. Like, that's, I don't think that's how that works.
Yeah.
But the feedback we did get that we were hoping for was,
mm-hmm.
hey, you guys are great, this idea is great, I don't think we're going to make it, but keep in contact with us.
Mm.
We want to hear from you again. We want to, like, you know.
Mm.
So I think that's great. Like,
because
that's the kind of thing that people don't have to say.
Mm.
And people can say, like, thanks so much. You know, enjoyed the pitch.
Mm.
Take it easy.
Yeah.
They don't have to say, keep in contact. They
yeah,
don't have
yeah,
to say,
yeah.
You know, bring us your next idea.
Mm.
They, you know, they don't have to say that stuff, and they did.
That means
so,
they really like looking forward to your maybe next project or
yeah,
you know, like, yeah,
I think so.
Something
I,
that maybe clicks to them.
Yeah. Like, I really think of all this stuff is like casting a movie.
Mm.
If that makes sense. Like, if I'm going out for a job interview,
mm-hmm.
they're not just looking for, like, we need a storyboard artist, you're a storyboard artist, check, done. You know, they're looking for, do we think this storyboard artist will match our sensibilities? Much in the same way that a movie will cast somebody,
mm-hmm.
they'll reject amazing actors
mm.
or actresses or whoever because it's not what is in their head
right.
as, you know, who this character is on,
yeah.
you know. So, and it's nothing to do with their acting ability, you know, or what they, you know, their body of work or anything.
Right.
Sometimes it just comes down to, yeah, this person doesn't really feel like this character. Okay, this one does.
Mm.
So I think that does apply to everybody in the industry. I think there is a level of, if you're hiring a board artist or a character designer
mm-hmm.
or something, they're looking for what you can bring to this production.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it's not a measure of how good you are as
no.
an artist. It's not a measure of
the style they're looking for.
Yeah, exactly. And does it mesh?
Yeah.
Or do they think it meshes?
Mm-hmm.
And then with the pitches, I think it's the same way.
Yeah.
I think that, like, a network, especially when you're dealing with, like, tons of money,
mm-hmm.
you know, that, like, a network is going, you know, we have, what do we want our network to be? What is it looking like? You know, we have X amount of dollars to invest. What is the thing that we want to gear that into?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't take it personally now
mm.
of, like, if I don't get that job or
yeah.
you know, I pitch it to some giant studio and they
mm.
say, no, thank you this time. Like, that's not to say that my work isn't good enough
no,
sometimes
no.
or anyone's work isn't good
exactly,
enough.
Exactly, yeah.
Sometimes it's just, yeah, this is great.
But that's not what they're looking for,
right.
you know? But your work might suit for other, you know, studios that
yeah.
that's probably, like, do something similar to your style or something.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. You know, when you even look at, like, Adventure Time, like Cartoon Network
yeah.
stuff, like, they have their own kind of sort of their...
They do, like,
style.
Their own kind
yeah.
of style.
Yeah, yeah.
Or, like, the type of comedy that they have.
Exactly, yeah.
yeah.
So I feel like each studio have different tastes in that kind of, like,
for
comedy
sure.
or, you know, or actions or... Yeah, so are you planning to stick with the first project, or are you moving on to second project?
I think both.
Okay.
We're going to, we've done the pitch with our first project.
Mm-hmm.
It still exists.
Okay.
It'll always be there.
Yeah.
I think it's a great idea. I think we have like an awesome, like I would love to see that show. So it's still there,
mm-hmm.
but we also want to keep doing more ideas, so that when we're meeting with somebody new, then we can kind of gauge like, hey, what are you looking for exactly? Because we have like three pitches that like, are you looking for, you know, something that skews to younger audiences, older? Do you want something kind of more action, something more comedic? Like, we'd like to branch out into those tailor what we pitch to what people...
What the client looking for, mm-hmm. and what people are looking for.
Yeah, but ultimately, I think you got to do... When it's that kind of creative thing, if you're trying to like, do something because you think it's going to sell, I think people can tell right away.
Yeah.
You know, I think it like reeks of like, oh, you think this is what we want, as opposed to what do you want? Like, what do you want to see?
Yeah.
So ideally we'll hit on both.
Mm.
Ideally we'll get something that we love that is also something that people are looking for, or that the people with the money are looking
exactly,
for.
Exactly.
You know?
Did you also like, when you work with your friend, like does he contribute like mostly like the writing part and you do mostly storyboard? Like how did you guys kind of like collaborate together?
It's been really like organic. Like we get together and just
bounce ideas.
Riff ideas. And what's great about the way that we work, I think, is that both of us, we'll just throw ideas out.
Okay.
And if it makes the other one laugh or it makes the other one interested, then it's probably a good idea.
Mm.
And if we're going, yeah, okay, then it's gone.
Yeah.
You know, or someone will throw like, oh, like I say all the time with him, I go like, oh, here's a dumb idea that I thought of, like, while I was walking over here, or while I was doing... And then sometimes it's a dumb idea, but it brings us to something else that we do love, you know? So it's been really collaborative. And then when it gets down to, like, when we did our pitch package, it came down to, okay, now we have to write a paragraph about this character that we came up with. Then Yao was like, okay, I got that. And he'd write it, and I would draw the character.
Yeah.
But then when I drew the character, it wasn't just like, it looks like this, done. It was like, hey, I have like these five ideas about what this character looks like. What do you think?
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And then he'd go, I like parts of this one, parts of this one, parts of this one. And then we'd kind of work together to establish what's going on in our brains and like what looks like us, what looks like what we want to be.
Yeah.
So... It's really like organic thing. It's been really fun.
I could feel the energy that you're really like, you know, really excited about this, you know, your own personal project with your friend. And then I really hope that this, you know, will go somewhere. And
thank
then
you.
You know, maybe I'll see in the TV and say, oh, okay, that's the show that he's working on.
Well, I hope so. But like, you won't wait till it's on TV. Like, you'll know about it.
Okay. Yeah,
I'll try to get you on it or something.
Hey, like, that's my show.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So I think we are almost end of the interview.
My goodness. Okay.
So maybe we could do like kind of like wrap up. Like I'll ask you like just maybe one like little question.
Sure.
Like,
and I'll answer quickly.
So like, you know, like we, you know, as we know, like I think what I like about you is also like you're very like hardworking. You know, always, you know, stick your nose and, you know, and keep working hard, but also at the same time you're a really humble person, I feel like. So what I was gonna ask you is like, what are the attributes, you know, as a story artist do you think people have to have, or like it's important to have?
It's a good question, and thank you for the compliment. I'm all warmed inside. I think the most important thing is with story art, like there's a saying that boarding is reboarding. You know,
so it's like consistent like revision, like.
Yeah, you might come up with an idea that you love, or like a shot composition that you love, or a sequence that you love, whatever it is, and it might not work for whatever reason. It just, you know, whatever the reason is, I think no matter what, you have to be prepared to let it go. You know, I think that's a really important attribute to say, hey, like I love this, but it doesn't work for the director, it doesn't work for the show, it doesn't work, whatever it is, it has to go. And then to have the mindset the mindset that I try to have is that when I'm boarding, it's just my first idea. It's the first draft, you know? And then what I want, now what I say that, like, I really want is that collaboration. Mm. I want it to work for the show. I want it to work for the director. Like, it's not about, oh, my brilliant ideas. Mm. It's about, you know, making the best product. Mm. So that should mean that I'm going to get revisions. That should mean that there's, you know, ideas. And hopefully, maybe, that, like, my supervisor or my director looks at it and says, like, I love that, mm-hmm. but what about even this? What about this better idea? Mm-hmm. And that it, like, sparks a new idea that's even better than what I did, mm-hmm. you know? So I think that attitude is really important, mm-hmm. to have the enthusiasm for the job and for the craft and to love it, but then at the same time be willing to let anything go.
Okay.
No matter what it is, no matter how hard you worked on it, or no matter how brilliant you think the idea is,
yeah.
The idea is not going anywhere. If it doesn't work this time, it's a tool in your tool belt. You can bring out that idea in another way, another time. It's always there.
Yeah.
But if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. It has to go.
Yeah.
And that's fine.
I think that's a really, like, also healthy way to think about it. Like, have you also ever tried to, like, you know, convince director or supervisor,
yeah,
like,
sure,
hey, like, I think this works.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like,
I learned, you know, that got kind of beaten out of me. But, like, not in a bad way.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I think when I first started, I was, you know, a director would say, okay, this isn't working, or this isn't great. And I'm like, no, it does, but let me tell you why, you know? And they go, it doesn't matter, you know?
Okay. He, like, already thought through, like, you know, like, all the scenarios.
Sure.
Like,
or sometimes it's just like, we don't have the budget for this. You know, or it's like, this needs to be, you boarded something that's like 30 seconds, it needs to be 5.
Okay.
You know, whatever it is.
Yeah.
That it's just like, it doesn't matter what it, why you love it,
yeah.
It's not working, and here's why. So, What I do sometimes still is I want to preserve, as we talked about, like, way earlier now, the feeling or the thought behind it.
Mm, okay.
So sometimes the director will say, like, okay, well, let's change it to this.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll say, okay, I'm happy to do anything.
Mm-hmm.
The reason I did it this way is because I wanted to convey X, Y, Z. And then it doesn't matter. That conversation's not about, I want to keep it the way I did it. That conversation is now about, does the new thing that we're doing, does it still convey that?
Mm.
You know? And then the director might say, oh, no, we're not trying to convey that, actually. You thought it, but actually it's, like, you thought it was dramatic. Actually, it's like, kind of a, it's more exciting than it is scary or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. That, like, either we're not on the same page and I need to get on the same page, the conversation becomes, how do I preserve that feeling? Whatever you change is great, but I just want to make sure that we get it, that, you know, it feels the way that I want it to feel.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah. So they still respect, you know, your opinions and then the way you come up with ideas.
Yeah.
But at the same time, like, I guess directors or supervisor, they'll be the kind of like the guide where, like, hey, you know, maybe this is too much, or maybe we can do something less, or, you know.
For sure.
Yeah.
And then sometimes it's just like the director or the supervisor goes, oh, yeah, I didn't see it that way. I saw it as X.
Mm.
And then you go, okay, great. Like,
so you kind of present the other perspective, like, maybe, you know, if he's only thinking about the X, you think about the Y, or
right.
The other side.
And then sometimes you get people that, you know, it meets in the middle.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes you get people that say, like, no, it's Y, you know.
You gotta
work with it. And then there's an element of picking your battles too.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
There's sometimes, you know, you get 5 things that get changed, and there's one that, like, you really don't want to change because there has to be a reason why, not just that I like it. It has to be like, this really speaks to me about something.
Yeah.
And then maybe because I want to really talk about that one, I'll let the other 4 go.
Mm.
You know? What am I really trying to preserve? Is it my ego, or is it the work?
Mm.
And if it's the work, I'll fight about it.
Mm.
If it's just something that I like, it's gone. Who cares?
Yeah.
You know, save that for my stuff.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
you know?
yeah. I think that's a lot of things that I think we talk about.
Yeah. I feel like I went very cerebral. I don't know if you're looking for more of the like craft or whatever, but hopefully it's interesting.
It was like super fun to just talk about this with you.
I'm fun chatting with you.
Yeah, and it's like already an hour past.
Yeah.
So I think that's pretty much it for today. And then thanks for tuning in, guys. If you guys still listening, you guys are amazing.
You are. Thank you.
Yeah,
I ramble. So
I'll see you guys next time. Right. Take care. Bye.